sound off. You don't wanna make me sound off. When you flow, it makes your sound off. I came to get this huge sound off. When we get on, watch us turn your sound off.
Hey y'all, this is Carla J with Sound Off with Carla J on BoxingSocialist.com. I am here in Las Vegas, Nevada at the Mayweather Gym, and I'm with the one and only Floyd Mayweather Sr. What's going on, Floyd?
Hey. Everything is good.
Everything is good. Is it splendiferous? That's the word of the day. You didn't get the memo? Floyd, y'all showed up and showed out Saturday. Now, did you think that it was going to be that easy? We knew he was going to win, but did you think it was going to be that easy?
I'm about to be honest with you. I didn't think it was going to be that easy. I thought that. But, you know, I'm back. It's amazing. Ain't no jazz. Lord, to see you come to life.
All right. That's the way it goes. Okay, so you said prior to the fight that you wanted to get Floyd back to the defense. You know, obviously it worked like a T because he barely even got touched in there. You know, it was like he put on a clinic in the ring. Now, it worked to a T. What were your thoughts on that?
Oh, it was just like I expected to go. Mm-hmm. And I think he's back now. I'm just saying because he wasn't moving his heat and stuff when I first came to his gym. Then a couple of days later,
he was moving his head.
Tried to hit it.
All right.
So, it ain't hard to get him to do what you need him to do. Just talk to him, explain what's supposed to be needed, and we get the job done.
Okay, so they said that, you know, 36, it looks like he was 26, and he found a fountain of youth, seemingly with you in his corner. What was the key? What was the secret to the success? What's the secret to the fountain of youth?
Well, one thing I can tell you is I'm back.
All right.
And you know, when the daddy's back, everything is finna work.
Mm-hmm.
In the right way. And you know what?
So he stops the interview so he can count his money. All right, talk to us about all the antics prior to the fight. You know, with the whole Ruben Guerrero thing. What were your thoughts on that? And what do you think about Ruben Guerrero? Do you think that he's on something?
The son?
No, the father.
Oh, hell yes. And I know one thing he's on for sure, and that's alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's stupid enough to think he can whoop me.
All right.
You know, and you got to be an alcoholic to think of something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And he's, you know, the other day when the weigh-in was going on, and I came, I got up because he was saying some things about me and my son. He said something about you know, my son's a woman beater and this and that. And he said, son, take right after his daddy.
Mm.
And that's when you'll see that I got out of the chair.
Mm-hmm.
Then I got in one of them chairs, and I jumped up on that chair, and I jumped on the stage.
Wow.
And chased his ass.
Mm-hmm.
And he won't tell you he was running, but he was.
Really?
Yes.
He didn't want none. He didn't want that. No. Now let's talk about the son. Do you think that that Robert Guerrero still can be at the top of the 147-pound division?
No.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't think he can be at the top of the 147-pound.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think he can be at the top. Floyd just whooped him just too easy.
Yeah.
He looked like a sub-novice.
Mm-hmm.
Not a novice.
Sub-novice.
No. Sub-novice.
Sub-novice.
Mm-hmm. He looked like a sub-novice fighter.
Wow.
Saying that Floyd didn't just whoop his ass and dominate him.
That's right. That's
all
right.
The way around. Any kind of way you want to look at it,
mm-hmm.
he did it.
That's right. Now, so sub novice is what he looked like in the ring. So do you think that there's any comeback from that? Because, I mean, Floyd Mayweather's not your average fighter. You know, so his performance versus Floyd Mayweather, who is, you know, at the top, the elitist of fighters, do you think that there's no coming back from that? He didn't put on that well of a performance?
Who?
Robert Guerrero.
No, Robert Guerrero didn't put on no performance at all. So, mm-hmm. You know, okay. Just tell me that Floyd, he told me he wanted to fight Floyd again.
Mm-hmm.
For what?
Right.
I mean, you know, I'm just saying, this time it ain't gonna be nothing but another magic kid. You know mm-hmm. that?
That's true. So, who do you see Floyd fighting next?
I really can't tell you who, because I really don't know the people right now that's in line to fight. Which don't get me wrong, anybody would want to fight Floyd because it's a payday.
That's right.
So anybody would want to fight him. Mm-hmm. So we ain't got no problem with getting no fights.
That's right. Well, what about, let me throw a couple of names out there. What about Amir Khan or Devin Alexander? Those are the top two that we hear circulating around. Well, what do you think about those two?
Both of those names are good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're going to get worse than what
Guerrero.
Guerrero.
All right.
So I ain't worried about it because I definitely want to make sure that mm-hmm. Amir Khan get his ass show enough to him.
Right.
So I got the right person to do it.
All right. I get a high five.
All right.
All right. Part one, Floyd Mayweather Sr. here at the Mayweather Gym in Las Vegas, Nevada. This is Carla J. with Sound Off with Carla J. on BoxingSocialist.com.
I'm not just talking.